5-Minute Fridays with Jonathan Paula. Hello and welcome to the show. It is Friday, January 22nd, 2016. As for what I've been working on, two big projects that unfortunately you're not going to see until March or later. The first of which is a YouTube movie awards ceremony in the style of the Oscars that I'm co-producing with my friend Adam Olinger over at Feud Nation. When we heard the Schmoes Know weren't doing their You Reviewers program this year, we thought, let's jump into that space. We've always had our own ideas and thoughts on how a show like this would be. So if you don't like the Academy Awards, stay tuned on YouTube on both of our channels the week afterwards. We'll be presenting our own version of the Best Picture and the Best Actor. And hopefully, we'll also be collaborating with a bunch of other reviewers here on the site. Second big project I'm working on is another road trip with my California friends, Danny, Ezra, and Joe. Six years ago now, we drove cross country from LA to Boston. A couple years after that, we went to San Diego. We did Yuma, Arizona, Lake Tahoe. You've seen a lot of these adventure vlogs. This year, in March, we are going to fly to Oregon and then drive down the entire Pacific Coast Highway, stop at the Redwoods National Forest, Alcatraz, the Hearst Castle. I am so looking forward to this. I've always wanted to explore Northern California, and a road trip with my friends is a perfect way to clear my head after a very stressful year. Keep an eye out for those adventure vlogs sometime in late March or early April. I cannot wait for this. But as for what's in the news this week, Flint, Michigan, and their water supply. 2 years ago, they switched from a clean supply to a lead-poisoned supply. The town officials seem to know about it, and even though some samples and tests of the water have read 2 times the toxic waste level, the citizens of Flint are still paying their water bill. The officials and the government haven't taken responsibility. They haven't resigned, and they certainly haven't gone to jail. This entire story is disgusting and deplorable, and frankly, unbelievable. Inside our country, one of our own towns, a great town like Flint, Michigan, which yes, has been on hard times for decades now, literally poisoning their own citizens and making them pay for it. It is disgusting that an American town in 2016 is literally drinking toxic waste out of their water faucets. There is so much more to this story that I can't get into here, but there is a link in the description below if you want to hear more information, because I feel like not enough people are talking about this, and it is really, really upsetting. Pivoting to something less upsetting, but something that still pissed me off this week, people ignoring emails. The fuck is wrong with you? When I send you a question or an explanation and I say, this requires your immediate attention, please respond as soon as possible, and then I don't hear anything back from you for 3 weeks, what's wrong with you? That's like basic social and internet etiquette. Just a quick reply like, hey, I got this, working on a response, get back to you later. That's all you need, just like one sentence, I'll get back to you later. But the fact that you didn't reply at all for weeks, that's just rude. That's just not polite at all to do that, especially if it involves any sort of business. Like, do your job, reply to emails. When, oh, I lost, I didn't see this one. Yes, you did. It's not that hard to keep track of your emails. Cool video of the week comes to us from Seth Meyers and the Late Night team spoofing Boston movies and Oscar contenders with their fake trailer for a film they call Boston Accent. Take a look.
And Boston Accent would not be complete without people talking about loyalty and Southie and all that other Boston stuff.
I mean, in, you know, Southie, loyalty's more important than a gun, you know?
I completely love this sketch, and my wife and I were just talking about this a couple weeks ago when we saw Black Mass. Movies in Boston always seem to be about the accent and about the area, and less on the story itself. I still love all these films, and from the area, I love all the jokes, but they definitely hit the nail on the head with that one. Real quick, let's do some Q&A. This one from Justin Mikesell. John, I hope you're well. Glad to see you're finally in your new home. Thank you. My question is, did you obtain special permission to use the dorm room in the first season of The Microwave Show, or did you just walk in and say, let's use this? It was definitely the latter. It was our friend who had already moved out a couple weeks early, and we just took over his dorm room and turned it into a laboratory, and, you know, microwave internet history was born. But yeah, we definitely did not get permission and came quite close to getting in trouble a couple times. Another question from Ben Ratner. What is your favorite anagram of a presidential frontrunner's name? Ben always has some fun questions. I'm going to go with Dad Lump Torn, and you can figure out who I'm talking about. And last but not least, revealing the winners of the last game of What's It we played here on the show. The one on the left was a square meal, correctly guessed by 10 people, but Dynamicsware Pro is the one I'm going to pick at random. And then the other one on the right, Twist of Fate. 13 people got that correctly, and Dynonis is the one I'm picking at random. Congratulations, fellas. Good work. No game this week. We don't have time for it, because that will do it for this episode of 5-Minute Fridays. Thank you, as always, for watching and listening. I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.